Hey there. Welcome to Life, Noggin. Donuts. Donuts everywhere. How will I consume all these donuts? Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. This is the show where I answer your questions about your world and mine. Let's get started with our first one. Amber asks, Dear Blocko, could popping pimples kill you? I'm afraid to pop. I feel you, Amber. My adolescent years were the worst. But pimples are actually pretty common and usually aren't that much of a concern. They form when your dead skin cells mix with excess oil, clogging the pores on your skin and causing swelling. Bacteria can grow there, leading to an infection and that whitish pus that some people love to pop. But popping pimples isn't really a good idea because it can cause the pimples to become even more inflamed, infected, and can even lead to permanent scarring. I've seen claims that there's this whole triangle of death area on your face where popping pimples can be deadly. Basically, the idea is that the veins in this area have a connection to your brain. So pop a pimple there, get an infection, and it could hypothetically lead back to your brain. Even if this is true, the risk still seems super low. But with all the bad things associated with popping pimples anyway, it's best just to avoid it. DiamondWolf25 Gaming asks, Dear Blocko, why do you feel hot when you have a fever? P.S. Keep up the great work, smiley face. Well, thank you so much. I really appreciate that. On the fever question, that might depend a bit on just why you have a fever in the first place. Fevers are basically when your body temperature is higher than it normally is. They can be triggered by a bunch of things, but infections like the flu or the common cold are often to blame. So while every fever isn't the same, if you're up against something like the flu, that change in temperature that you feel is essentially your body's way of fighting the infection. By itself, a mild fever is usually pretty harmless, even though it might not feel that great. But if you have a severe or abnormally prolonged fever, you should seek medical attention right away. And now it's time for questions about me or my world. Semen asks, Dear Blocko, what is the happiest thing that happened in your world, sad face? Well, hopefully this story can cheer you up. There's a place called Puppy Island in my world. I once got lost at sea and crash landed on this island. The puppies saw that I was in a bit of a pickle, so they all fused together to create one big puppy, and he swam me back home. Aren't they precious? With their 18 eyeballs and several hands. Yes, you are so precious. Yes, you are. Pink Master asks, Dear Blocko, what types of creatures are unique to your world? Oh, we have lots of creatures in the Life Noggin world that you humans don't have. There's Honk Honk, half bird, half horn. There's Shrimpy Danielson, a jumbo shrimp with big old arms who specializes in yelling at traffic. And of course, we have Nunus. They're cute little balls of fur and, well, they go boom. So dangerous. Ow, so cute. Ow. I just want to love you. Ow. So do you have any questions about me, my world, or your world? Let me know in the comment section below and make sure you use the hashtag DearBlocko so I can find it. Thank you so much for all of your questions and supporting this series. It's been really fun. If you want to watch more Dear Blocko, you should check out the previous episode we did. If you hang upside down for more than a couple of minutes, your heartbeat starts to slow and your blood pressure increases. Being in an inverted state can even increase the blood flow to your head. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.